Hi everyone, welcome back. So here we are going to talk about another important point, which is the deep copy and shallow copy. Okay, so we already seen that whenever I'm assigning some object like this, where I have a property a equal to 70, and then what I'm doing, y equal to x, and what if I'm changing something in y, y dot b equal to 80, then my x is also getting impacted, right? So this is because I'm doing a shallow copy, and the reference are shared. When you do this assignment, the reference of x object is shared with the y, so whatever the change in the y is also changing in x, okay? Because both are pointing to the same memory. But how can we avoid this? We can avoid this with this json.stringify. So what this json.stringify will do, it will convert first object into the string, then again it will parse it. So it is actually trying to do the delink of the object. I mean, it has removed the link of that object from the previous object. So you can see new object.c is 90, then x is not impacted, right? X is still having 70 and 50, right? Because it is stringifying it and then parsing it back, that is the right way of doing it. And we have already talked about object.assign, that object.assign is not going to do the shallow copy, it is doing a deep copy. So whatever is there in the x will be copied to the new object, and whenever you are adding something to this new object, that is not impacting the x object. It's a deep copy because I'm creating the new object from object.assign. Similarly, you can also write your own code. What the code is, clone object, okay? So what this object is doing, what this function is doing, clone object, and this function is just taking function object as an argument, and we are iterating onto that object. We are using for in loop to look into each and every property. Then we are checking if this object is a nested object or not. If it is not a nested object, assign that property to the clone object. Otherwise, if the property in the object is representing a nested object, then it's a recursively call. Recursive call, so you call the clone object again by passing that property, right? So we can also use a clone object x here, and we can assign this to something. So this is the new object I created, right? So Z is having both the properties, and now if you are adding some new property to it, it's not impacting X, right? So this is also a deep copy of example. We can talk about the other methods which are actually doing a deep copy, like concat.splice. Splice 0 will give you the separate copy. So if you wanted to do a method call with the pass by value, then create a copy, deep copy of an object, of an array, or of a collection, then only pass it to the function. So whatever the function is going to do with that object will not be impacting anything else. So here, this is how we create a deep copy of an array, concat slice, or we also use, like, there is an array, something like this. And whenever we do a dot map and write a callback function inside it, it is always going to give us the new array without changing the existing array. So that is the beauty of the map filter method. What is missing here? Okay, you got the new copy of array. Similarly, there is a method filter. You can also provide some criteria. So I is greater than, let's consider it as a 5. Okay, so it will give you the new array without changing the existing array. If you can see, the existing array is still the same. Okay, so slice, concat, map, filter, all these are actually immutable, showing immutable behavior. They are not changing the existing array. They are always giving us the new array. So it's a deep copy. Whatever we are changing in the different array will not impact the existing array. Okay, this is all about the deep copy and shallow copy, and I already talked about the enumerable property. If you are using object.assign, if the property is enumerable is false, then you cannot copy it into the new object. Then you need to use this way of clone object method. It will manually doing a copy of each and every property into another object, or you can use this method. Okay, thanks everyone.